Welcome everybody, with you Dr. Magdi Abdelrazik, Consultant of Infectious Disease, Hepatology and Gastroenterology. Our topic today about MRSA. This is Staphylococcus aureus. This organism is resistant to most known antibiotics. This organism resistant to methicillin and also to penicillin, oxacillin, all these groups of beta lactams, the organism is resistant to these antibiotics. As regards this organism, Staphylococcus aureus usually is flora and it does not affect our bodies, but some of the strains is pathogens. This organism sometimes present in nostril, in on the skin or in the gut. Sometimes it become pathogens, can lead to abscess, can lead to boils, and also this organism can lead to fever, anorexia, headache, and shivering. Also this organism, we can divide it to three categories: hospital acquired, number P, community acquired, and this we discovered it in between 1990 and 2000 years. This organism, community acquired, present in prisons and in nursing homes. Number three, or category number three, is livestock acquired MRSA through animals or pet animals. As regard hospital acquired, this organism MRSA present in ICU, in hospitals, through contact with the patient. Some doctors or some nurses is a carrier to this organism without any manifested symptoms or signs. So this organism can transmit it from doctors or sister or from patient to patient, especially patient who admitted in hospitals for long time. Also the patient with weak immunity, like who take cortisone for long time, or diabetic, or with organ transplantation, or who take medications to suppress immunity. As regard categories P, community acquired, this is in prisons, also in intravenous drug abusers, also present in nursery homes. All these patients, all these persons exposed to MRSA through contact. They are present in confined places. Category 3, livestock with pet animals. Pet animals can transmit MRSA to the owner of the pet animals. And conversely, the owner can transmit also MRSA to their pet animals. So the prevention, first hand wash, and also sanitary precautions during operation, also sanitary precautions in the hospital. If any patient with culture of MRSA, so we isolate this patient. As regard to doctors or nurses, if they are carrier, we give them another job away from the patient, and we also encourage of hand washing and the sanitary precautions in the hospital. Also, prevention in military barracks, and also in prisons. Also, we have to take sanitary precautions to avoid MRSA. Also, with livestock, also very important hand washing and sanitary precaution to avoid transmit MRSA between the animals and human being. As regards the diagnosis of the organism through culture, and we can also discover this organism through quantitative PCR or rapid latex agglutination test. As regards the treatment, few antibiotics can kill this organism, like linezolid, like vancomycin, and also teicoplanin. These antibiotics can affect this organism. Also locally, if there is abscess and we find MRSA, we can put mupirocin. Very important to know that this organism is now present all over the world, especially also in children or in the people with weak immunity. As regards this organism, very important to make awareness about this organism, and we advise the doctors don't prescribe linezolid or vancomycin except in cases of MRSA. Otherwise, new strains will appear, also resist these antibiotics. So keep linezolid, teicoplanin, and also vancomycin to cases of MRSA only. We know that the organism transmits its genes through natural selection or through horizontal gene transfer. As regards this organism, there is precautions all over the world as to this organism. So as I told you, very important in our hospital to take sanitary precautions to avoid and kill this organism. Thank you very much.